My name is Bi Guangwen. I'm from Shanghai Nuclear Engineering Research and Design Institute. Nuclear Engineering Research and Design Institute is founded in 1970s, designed China's first commercial nuclear power plant, Qinshan NPP. And since 2007, SNERDI has turned to AP1000 localization and CAP1400 R&D. Today, my topic is research on thorium-uranium breeding recycles for thermal reactors. As we know, thorium-uranium fuel cycle is attractive for advanced fuel cycle. Here is generation 4 system goals. Yeah. Including sustainability, economics, safety and reliability, proliferation resistance, and physical protection. For thorium-uranium fuel cycle, there are several potential benefits, including abundant thorium resource, maybe 3 or 4 times of uranium, and lesser production of transuranicals. Including Ma, and its chemical the thorium dioxide is chemical very stable, and the thorium dioxide has better thermal physical properties compared to uranium dioxide, and there is gamma radiation emitted from the short-lived daughter products. For example, thorium-208, and it provides radiation protection for proliferation. And the uranium-233's eta is greater than 2 over a wide range of neutron spectrum, so it can be bred in thermal energy. However, there is also potential changes in thorium-uranium fuel cycle, and the most important one is reprocessing. There are 2 main reasons for this. One reason is high gamma radiation emitted from the short-lived dot products and uranium-2, and the second one is chemical index for thorium dioxide-based fuel. Let's move on. Neutronics analysis for breeding of thorium-uranium fuel cycle. Here is a picture, eta versus neutral energy for uranium-3, uranium-5, and plutonium-9. From this picture, we can the eta of U3 is larger than 2 in the whole neutron energy range, but for uranium-5, its eta is lower than 2. So the thorium-uranium can be bred in the thermal energy, but the uranium-5 or other U8 plutonium-9 fuel cycle is not bred in the thermal energy. Here is a commercial of breeding ratio the definition. The commercial breeding ratio can be written as this equation. Capture rate of photons divides absorption rate of physics. For thorium-2 uranium-3 system, it can be written as this formulation. Here we can separate the number density of thorium-2 and uranium-3 out of the integral. And the integral can be defined as the commercial operating performance index. And then the equation can be changed into like this. If we want to the conventional breaking ratio is larger than 1, and we can change this equation to this. So if we want to achieve thorium-uranium breeding recycle, the content of U3 in thorium must less than the CBPI. For the CPPI, there are two major parameters. One is the macroscopic sigma C and sigma A for thorium-2 and uranium-3. And another one is the neutron spectrum. Here is the neutron spectrum for PWR 17 by 17 lattice from beginning of life to ending of life. From this picture, we can see that it remains unchanged through the cycle. The next picture is the sigma C thorium-2 divides sigma A U3, and it only depends on the energy. We can provide this spectrum and the ratio of sigma, and we can get the CBPI for standard 17 by 17 lattice. Its value is about 2%, and for can do reactor with camflex 14-3 bundles, the CBPI's value is about 1.45. So if we want to implement the thorium-uranium breeding recycle, the enrichment of U3 in thorium fuel is much less than CBPI. The third one is research on thorium breeding recycles in PWR. Here is the roadmap design for thorium breeding recycle in PWR in SNERDI. And there are two stages. The first one is for production of initial uranium-3, and the plutonium from spent used fuel is extracted and mixed with thorium dioxide, fabricating the pure source fuel and enter the reactor for incal cycle. And after the radiation, we can extract the uranium-3 from the pure source spent fuel and extract uranium-3 and mixed with the thorium from here and fabricating U3 source fuel and re-entering the reactor for incal cycle. And the first stage is a single recycle, and the second one is a multi-recycle, and the U3 can be recycled through the U3 source fuel. Here is the core design. The first stage employs used pure socks mixed core, just like the used MOX core design. And the second stage employing used U3 socks mixed core, but the U3 socks is on the periphery of the core, just like a blanket in FBR. Here is the used pure socks mixed core loading pattern design. The mixed core with 37% pure socks fuel assemblies loading, and the pure socks fuel assembly design with plutonium enrichment zoning, avoiding the power peaking factors in outside of the pure socks fuel assembly. there is no pure source fuel assembly allocated in controlled place. The next one is U3 SOX mixed co-loading pattern design. All the U3 SOX fuel assemblies are located in the periphery of the core as blanket, and the reactivity of U3 SOX is quite low, so it satisfies the low leakage loading pattern in nuclear industry. And the full core performance are dominated by use in the core. Here presents the U3 SOX fuel assembly design. For the design, the key is balance between the reactivity and the commercial operating ratio, or fee cell inventory ratio. It's just the same parameters in different form. And through a larger investigation, the fee cell enrichment in thorium fuel is about 1.94%. Here is the reactivity CBR and FR versus burn up. Here is the case one result with 70% fuel assembly with standard fuel load design. The pellet out radius is 0.496 centimeter. And this is case B, modified thicker fuel load design. The pellet out radius is sinking to 0.5 centimeters. To improve the CBR, we insert 24 solid rods of zirconium in guide tubes. So the CBR is larger than 1, and the FIR is 1.07 at 40 megawatt day. For U3 SOX core design, the thorium-uranium breeding for performance, the average discharge burn-up of U3 SOX fuel is 28 gigawatt day per 10 heavy metal, and the thorium-uranium-2 and thorium-2-uranium-3 breeding is achieved in U3 SOX fuel. Here is the content of different nuclides. We can see the FI is 1.07. Here is presented the key fuel management results, including F.H, Fq, and moderate temperature coefficient at BOL, ARO, and the EOL shutdown margin. From this result, here is the nuclear design criteria. From the results, we can the key parameters satisfy the nuclear design criteria. The next one is core reactivity feedback parameters. For mixed core with plutonium fuel loading, the core has similar impacts with MOX on core reactivity feedback parameters, including MTC boron coefficients and the Doppler coefficients. But for mixed core with U3 SOX loading, on the periphery of the core has no visible impact on core reactivity feedback parameters compared with the reference for used core. Here is the boron worth. From this picture, we can the boron worth of pure SOX core is similar as the MOX core, larger than the four use core. From the node one, we can see the use resource core is similar as the four use core. And here is the core kinetical parameters. These parameters is in the range of the safety limits. And here is the spin field characteristics. For plutonium bearing fuel, both MOX fuel and the pure source, its radioactivity, radio toxicity, and decay heat, and the gamma ray heat is larger than the reference one. The reference one is use fuel. For the SOX fuel, pure SOX and U3 SOX, the 2.6 MeV gamma ray intensity is more larger than the uranium-based fuel use and MOX from these three peak. But for U3 SOX, the other parameters except this parameter is lower than the the uranium-based fuel. Here is the radio toxicity and decay heat scheme. From these two pictures, we can see that the value of the U3 SOX in about 50,000 years, the value is increased. This is because of uranium-233 decay. And here is the gamma ray spectrum. From this picture, we can see that the intensity of 2.6 MeV gamma ray is larger than larger than uranium fuel. This is because cesium-208 from decay of uranium-232. So it's we must concern about this gamma ray in the reprocessing or refabrication for SOX for thorium fuel. And here is PWR thorium uranium breeding fuel cycle scheme. Maybe just like the last presentation from Japan. The first stage is U3 build up, and the seed is reactor grade plutonium from spent use. And the second stage is U3 breeding recycle. And here is the power sharing. For use is about 80%. For pure SOX is about 8.6%. And the remaining are from U3 SOX fuel. Compared with PWR uranium plutonium fuel cycle, the U3 mono recycling with U3 SOX can save natural uranium is about 30%, slightly larger than MOX single recycle. And for U3 trial recycling with U3 SOX, the saving is about 20%. Here is the high-level waste and spent nuclear fuel of disposal. For recycle option, HLW and SNF mass is much lower than one through cycle. But this here just for the waste mass. If we measure it using the water, maybe it just low so much. And the next is fuel cycle cost. This analysis is based on the unit cost. This value is about is from January 2011, before the Fukushima accident. So the natural uranium price maybe is higher than that today. Now we are here for U3 trial recycling with U3 stocks. The fuel cycle cost is 18% more than the U's once through cycle. If we want to this point decrease to here, the use reprocessing and fuel refabrication, Thorex reprocessing price must down to here, down here. And if the natural uranium price increase to $312 per kilogram uranium, here is the value. If we want to this value down to this point, the U's reprocessing must decrease to $500. And with other parameters in assumption values. And if the natural uranium price go here, 520, the value may be were equal. So in today's technology and the economic assumption, the U3 trial recycling with U3 stocks presented in this presentation may be more cost than use one through cycle. Let's move on the research on thorium uranium breeding in Kandu. It's very shortly. Here is the roadmap for thorium breeding recycle in Kandu. There are also two stages. First is for U3. U3 build up, but the site is not plutonium. The site is slightly enriched uranium, and the thorium is discrete fuel rod, and with separated low enrichment uranium fuel salt. Compiles mixed bundles. And the second one is U3 recycle, just like PWR. Here is the numerical results. From this picture, we can see if the initial content of U3 is less than CBPI, it can be bred for breeding recycle. And here is presents the decrease the powers impacts on reactivity and breeding. In order to improve the breeding and maintain the reactivity, we should decrease our power to decrease the fission products impacts. And this is the build is for build up of ignition U3. It employed SEU thorium mixed bundles. For this bundle, directly self recycle is employed, avoiding for the reprocessing process. And the central thorium dioxide fuel rod is recycled with three cycles, but the outer uranium fuel rod will be discharged each cycle, and we can replace a new uranium fuel rod. Let's move to a summary. Breeding of thorium 2 uranium 3 can be achieved for thermal reactors if the number density ratio of U3 to thorium 2 is less than CPPI of the specified fuel lattice or system. It shows that thorium uranium breeding recycle is technically feasible in current PWS based on core design, neutronics evaluation, and fuel analysis. Roadmap design for thorium uranium breeding recycle in CANDU reactors was also investigated in SNERDI. That's all. Thank you very much.
Have you investigated in situ breeding in fast spectrum reactors, like is being done in the United States with both sodium and gas cooled reactors?
For fast reactors, this neutronic analysis also correct, but the value, but the specified value, I didn't perform any analysis. Maybe you can try. Thank you.
I would think, in view of the cost of reprocessing and fuel manufacturing, maximizing the burn up should be one of the goals. Now you go to CANDU types of systems which have the worst possible burn up. That does not seem to be very logical.
Maybe for this PWR design, the burn up of U3 stocks is rather low, but it's based on current PWR core design. If we want to increase the burn up of the U3 stocks fuel, that in current PWR, the breeding of thorium uranium may not be achieved. So the reprocessing is necessary for thorium uranium in current PWR. Yeah.
Tsumoto. Motto Kinoshita of University of Tokyo. Just a small comment about the burn-up potential of the thorium dioxide. I think Julian Kelly will make a presentation later. Compared to the UO2, it has high melting temperature, and the fission gas retention capability is much could be better. We have to check, but the 1960s data shows very promising view. So you can make maybe 20%, 30%, I don't know, higher burn up than UO2 fuel. So it has a better potential. Just a comment.